Today we're going to talk about the fan extender. What I mean by that is, right now we only have a fan or two that we can run off of here and maybe several off here, but we can't control the speed with the exception of here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you a way to add additional fans that you can control. So one of the reasons that we're going to use it is because our stepper drivers sometimes get hot depending upon which ones we use, and we need a fan to keep them cool. So the first thing I'm going to start with is I'm going to install the stepper driver, which I pre-prepped with the jumpers. So I first have to find the enable pin, which is right here, then rotate it over, and I know the enable pin is here, so I'm going to place that over the X port for the stepper driver. Next, I'm going to tell you about some pins. We have our pins over here for our servos. The first row is ground, the next row is 5 volts, and the last row is our digital pins. And the order of those is digital pin 11, 6, 5, and 4. So in order to install the stepper extender right here, we have to place it over those pins and then put it with a little bit of pressure down on the board. So that's how we install our actual stepper driver extender for fan extension. And what it's going to do is it's going to allow us to connect some fans. So I'm going to connect one of them over here for our one fan, which is right down here, and then I'm going to connect the other fan over here, and I'll extend this out in a minute so you can see it better when I do a test, but let me slide it on real quick here. So much for real quick. There we go. And so that's going to rest over here to keep it cool for this example. So the next thing we need to know about is powering it. And because we have to use 12 volts to power it, we need to know what our pins are. So we have two sets of pins here. One set right here is the actual 5 volt pin and ground, but we want the 12 volt set of pins and ground. So we're going to take a jumper for the wire and we're going to extend it so we know that ground's here. So let me orient this correctly and we're going to place it on there. Now to power our stepper, or excuse me, our fan extender, we need to know what our pins are. So this is ground and this one is our voltage. If it's incorrect, you can always turn this in the other direction to get the desired effect you're looking for. So we're gonna place that on there. So we're all set with that. So the next thing that we need to do is actually load the Marlin firmware. So to do that, we need to connect our big side of our USB serial cable to the board, and the other side will be connected to the computer, and if you didn't already hear it, there was a beep. Okay, to start with, I wanna show you the actual pin layout for the board, so I'm gonna zoom in on this. Information that I just related to you is actually written here, so if you want to take a closer look and figure out how to set it up, but normally it's going to be digital pin 6 and digital pin 5 that actually run the fan extender. And then here's our voltage over here for ground, and then 12 or 24 volts. Granted, keep in mind that the fan extender only runs on 12 volts. Okay, so let's go over to the Marlin folder and open up Marlin bugfix-2.0.x. Then we're going to open up the Marlin subfolder. Then we're going to open up the source folder and then the core folder. And inside the core folder, we're going to open up boards.h. And inside boards.h, we're going to do a search on MKS. And we have several to choose from. But the one that we're interested in is the board underscore MKS underscore Gen underscore 1.3. And the reason being is that this is for both version 1.3 or version 1.4. So we're going to copy this. And we're going to close out of here. We're going to go up a directory, then another directory. Then we're going to open up marlin.ino. Okay, now that we're in marlin.ino, we're going to go to the configuration.htab. We're going to do a search on motherboard. And as you can see, right now it's got board underscore ramps underscore 1.4 underscore EFB. So we're going to paste what we just copied. Next, we're going to do a search on the A4988. And as you can see right here, there's something new in the 2.0 version where they actually set it up so that it's default to the A4988 or assumed to be. So in that case, I mean, we don't have to change anything, but I just want to show you something real quick. If we remove the comments for the X, the Y, the Z, and we'll say E0. If you wanted to change it to a different stepper driver to get the correct configuration, you would do something like copy it, and we'll put it on the Y for instance. So we'll do DRV8825, and that would be a different stepper driver. Keep in mind this is 1/32nd of a step, and this is 1/16th of a step. So if we needed to modify, let's say, let's do a search on max underscore. If we needed to modify default access steps per unit, in the case of the Y, it has doubled the number of steps, so we need to double the number to 160 from 80, pardon me. So we don't really have to worry about that too much in this example, but at least you know now. So we're going to go over to the configuration.h tab for advanced. So it's config underscore adv dot h. And we're going to search on controller. And what we have here is the ability to control our fan with this over here that says define use controller fan. So what we need to do is remove the comment to enable it. We then also want to set a particular pin. So we're going to remove the comment for define controller fan pin. Right now it's -1. So we're going to backspace over the -1 and we're going to say that it is pin 6. The next thing that I want to do is I want to change this over here so that it doesn't turn off 60 seconds like default, but 5. So that you can see it actually in the video without waiting a minute. And then I'm going to change the fan speed to 215. Now the range is from 0 to 255. 255 obviously being the full speed and 0 being off. So keep that in mind. And now in order to load it, we have to go to the tools, ports, and make sure that we have a port selected, which we do. In this case, it's COM port 3, and that we have the right chipset selected, which is the Mega 2560. So all we have to do is press the upload button, which will compile our changes and then upload to our board with our USB connection. Okay, I've hooked up the power off camera, and now I'm going to plug it in. Now keep in mind to keep your hands away from the board when working with it energized or having voltage run through it. Okay, we're in the Pronterface folder. I'm gonna open up the Pronterface executable. I'm gonna connect to the MKS Gen version 1.4. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna move the motor 100 millimeters. By pressing right here and let you see what happens to the fan after it moves. So here we go. So So now I'm going to press the motor's off button and let you see what happens after 5 seconds. So if you like my tutorial, please press the like button and subscribe, and thank you for your time.